Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss module 1, industrial drives and application. In that we are going to discuss about your difference between AC drives and DC drives, and the next topic of this first module is dynamics of motor load system. Okay. Now here what the comparison between DC drives and AC drives. Okay, here the power circuit and the in DC drives the power circuit and control circuit is simple and inexpensive. Okay, the power circuit which is designed for the DC drives is very simple, and also the cost is very less, so it is inexpensive. But in the case of AC drives, the power circuit and control circuit are very complex and it is also costly. But in the case of DC drives, and it requires frequent maintenance. For DC drive, frequently we have to maintain, we have to make the maintenance. But in the case of AC drives, less maintenance. Maintenance is not required that much for AC. Okay, and here in DC drives, in case of DC drives, generally you know that DC motor, the commutator is very bulky and it is costly as well as heavy in the case of DC. But in the case of AC, the problems are not there. It is inexpensive, and actually here we are having in AC drives we are having squirrel cage motor in the case of induction motors. Okay, particularly squirrel cage induction motor is very inexpensive. Okay, wow. But in the case of DC drives, it is very costly, bulky and heavy. Okay, and here the in DC drives the fast response and wide speed range, but in solid state control the speed range is wider. Okay, the fast response can be achieved in DC drives, and here it is limited. In AC drives it is limited. The speed and design ratings are limited due to commutations. This is very important. Because of commutations in DC drive, the speed and design ratings are limited. But in the case of AC drives, the speed and design ratings have very high upper limit. Okay, so this is having very high upper limit, but here it is having very limitations. Now I'm going to discuss about the applications of your electric drives. So they are having the complete applications we are going to discuss in the last module. Okay, wow. So the electrical drives plays an important role in this kind of applications, that is paper mill, cement mill, textile mill, sugar mill, steel mills, electric traction, petrochemical industries, electrical vehicles. Here the electric traction, the traction can be depends upon the drives we are using, and also the traction can be AC traction or DC traction. If the traction is AC, then we can go for AC drive. The traction is DC, then we can go for DC drive. These are the applications of your electrical driver. Now we are coming to the important point of the second topic of your module 1, dynamics of motor load systems. Okay, actually here the motor torque and load torque will not be same. When it is implemented practically, the motor torque and load torque cannot be same. Okay, whenever motor generally drives a load through some mechanism, okay, motor generally drives a load through some mechanism, it can be the mechanism is nothing but your some transmission system. And here the motor the motor will be rotated in a rotary motion, but the load may be or may not, the load may not rotate in the rotary motion, it may go undergo translation motion, and the load speed may be different from that of the motor, as I said earlier, because the load depends upon the load parameters. The load speed and motor speed cannot be same. The load speed load will have different parts, and these parts sometimes will rotate and some parts will not rotate, so the load speed will not be same. Okay, so as that of your motor speed. And here this T is nothing but your motor torque, and this TL is nothing but your load torque, and this omega is nothing but your speed of your shaft. Okay, speed of your shaft. See, your motor torque is rotating in the clockwise direction, your load torque is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so here generally if you see, your motor will be motoring operation means and see, this TL is equal to instantaneous values of your load torque referred to as motor shaft. Okay, and generally your load torque includes friction torque as well as windage torque of your motor. Okay, the load torque always includes friction torque and windage torque of the motor. And here the fundamental motor for the motor load system, the fundamental torque equation is given by T minus TL into d omega divided by dt into j into omega m, where T is nothing but your motor torque and this TL is nothing but your load torque, j is nothing but your moment of inertia, omega m is nothing but your the speed of your motor shaft. Okay, and see here, first you keep this j constant and differentiate this time with respect, differentiate this speed with respect to time. Next, you keep this omega m constant, differentiate this moment of inertia of the motor load system with respect to time. Here you see generally if you want to get the equilibrium state of the electrical drive, the motor torque should be is equal to load torque. When this condition will come means motor torque is equal to load torque means whenever the speed diminishes as the time decrease, as the time increase. Okay, as the time increase, your speed diminishes means then your motor torque will be is equal to load torque. That time that electrical drives will achieve the equilibrium state. Here this term will be generally negligible and this moment of inertia will be is equal to zero. Okay, if you differentiate this this is very very small, so and this will be negligible, so you will get the torque is equal to TL into J into d omega m divided by dt. And this equation is applicable only if the variable inertia drives such as mine winders, reel drives, industrial robotics, this equation will be applicable. And here in this very very important, here in this dynamic equation you see your motor will be always rotated in the clockwise direction, means nothing but whenever a car if you see this one, you are taking the first quadrant operation of electrical drive, whenever so this is nothing but your first quadrant. Okay, if your car is like this, your car, this is uphill. If the car is moving from down to up, okay, what will happen? This motor will produce the enough speed to make forward. Okay, but this load, the load will pull you due to gravitational force. The load will be the load will pull your car down, but the motor will provide enough speed to make the car upward. Okay, so that is nothing but motoring operation. If the drives, electrical drives supports your this one motion of your motor, then it is said to be motoring. Okay, so that this all this discussion we will do in the four quadrant operation of electrical drives. This is very very important equation. If you want to discuss this dynamics load motor load system, this is the basic equation. With this basic equation we are going to discuss. I said when when the electrical drive goes to equilibrium state means if T is equal to, that is Tm is equal to Tm, Tm is equal to TL, that time your electric drive goes to equilibrium state. Tm is equal to TL, that time your electrical drives goes to equilibrium state. When the equilibrium state achieves means if you discuss speed, if the time decreases, sorry, if the time increases, this is nothing but your time. If the time increases, your speed decreases, then your motor torque will be equal to load torque. You will get the equilibrium state of your electrical drive. Okay, so this value will be very very negligible, so this will be is equal to zero. So you will have only T is equal to TL plus J into, this is nothing but J into d omega m divided by dt, d omega m divided by dt. So this is in a way applicable for the variable inertia drives. Okay, thank you students.